Whoa, webcam. What the? Oh, right, my light's not on. Huh. Okay. Cancel that. There we go. I'm a professional, guys, I swear. Alright, Winter, I realize you're impatient. You'll come when you damn well please. I learned a little bit from fighting you before. That Miss Perry, though, that hurts. Ooh, the roll catch. You know, long swords, Lothric knight swords in this case, straight swords. It's easy to be successful when you spam them like that. It really is. 1-2 delay, 1-2 delay, 1-2 delay. It's easy. It was a decent fight, I suppose, but it's easy. Easy to win, hard to fight against. I'd like to summon someone, please. Fuzzy. Doesn't help that I'm using a dagger, I suppose. I don't have the reach, I don't have the damage. I did decent for what I had to work with. Had I been using this, it might have been a little bit different, but I wasn't using that. So. Hey, that Corvian Scythe, though. That's not a bleed buff. I am surprised. Back off of that. Nope, you went to the other side. Oh, that was a good little bait I had. Ouch. Good parry. Props. Props. Yeah, that was a good fight. I liked that. I liked my little maneuver for the backstab that I pulled. That was pretty satisfying, I've got to say. Not every day where you fight someone who's using a scythe who actually is knowledgeable on how to use it. It's a really rare moment. It's rare enough to see a scythe, but even more rare to actually fight someone who knows what they're doing. It's pretty nice. He didn't two-hand very much. Didn't take advantage of the two-handed moveset. I think the two-handed moveset's a little better than the one-handed moveset. That's just my opinion on the matter. I like its two-handed moveset a lot, but I mean, hey, oh well. So, with this weapon, I'm not overly fond of it. If its attack lasted a long time, similar to how it lasts with the Tailbone Spear, like if it shot that thing for that same duration of time, I feel like that would be a very large improvement to the weapon. Same if its hitbox was wide, the way that the spear's hitbox is on that skill. Because that makes for a very large difference in how successful it is. Hello, backstab attempt. I wanted an R1. Was that a squeak that I just heard from outside, or was that in-game? I couldn't tell. Either way, I just flawlessed someone who's using Onikiri and Ibudachi with this thing. That's weird. That's really weird. I'm just checking something on my phone real quick, because I'm not going to just walk away from the game, especially after summoning someone, and I'm going to make sure that that squeak was not Becca. So at work today, they found a cat. It was climbing into people's cars, like sitting on the engine and whatnot, and sitting on spare tires underneath the trucks and stuff like that. And it was just this little tiny adorable kitten. It was so cute. It was like, it was just like this little tiny little kitten. It was so cute. So calm and docile and just overall well-tempered. I took a picture of it. It's on my phone. I'll show you guys in a minute. Okay, there is some lag. I was just gonna spam parry and make fun of him a little. That works, though. I still do wish that the hitbox was a little wider. I feel like it's just narrow in comparison, but just gotta compensate and get used to it, predict a little bit better, and go from there. Still, I don't like the weapon. Look at the kitty. Wow, green screen. Make it look like a demon. It's cute. It's a very cute little kitten. Just have to take my word for it. Slow. So we have a Hollow Slayer Greatsword. That works well enough, I suppose. Tried to roll. I didn't roll. That'll happen. Oh well, an attempt was made. I flawed someone with this weapon. I'm fine. I can't even be mad that I lost a couple fights. Like, it's a hard weapon to work with. And I flawlessed someone with it. Like, that's worth being happy about on its own. That's good enough for me. Now it's Black Knight Great Axe time. So we get to swing it around. Oh, the Black Knight Great Axe. Oh, Dark Souls 1 Black Knight Great Axe. Those were the days. Those were terrifying days, but those were the days. Dark Souls 1 pre-patch Black Knight Great Axe. Mm-hmm. Yep. I remember that. Take that. I'm just gonna pop that. Aw. Rude. Couldn't have just been a little closer. That's an easy move to sight parry anyway. Easy attack to sight parry. All things considered, I think I did okay. My nose itched, in case you couldn't tell. I didn't feel like just doing that for the sake of doing it. There's a method to the madness, I swear. Wouldn't that be weird if I just, you know, felt like doing that just to do it? Alright, let's pick up our souls. Let's stop this little losing streak. I've lost enough times for the point in the video we're at, I think. Just saying. I'm gonna do better from now on. Gundyr's halberd. And Mannequin Claws in the offhand. Way bad timing. Worth the trade. Okay. Thank you, Stunlock. That was not cool. Yeah, back off. There we go. That's what I wanted the first time. That was better timing. Better distancing. And very ballsy. I just realized how low my health was. If it had actually gotten the second tick on me, then I would have died. Clutch berries, though. So good. I do like the moveset on this. That attack rating, though, is so stupid. And then Warcry on top of that. It's just silly damage. That's what that is. Are you gonna do anything ever? I'll be nice. That was just satisfying. It was a mean thing to do, but it was satisfying. And I wasn't in the mood to keep chasing him down. I really honestly was not. I don't know, I haven't been in the mood for that recently, you know? It's like, yeah, I could, but do I really want to? And the answer is definitely not. So, meh. It is what it is. So, I'm gonna start looking now rather than later to determine which weapon I feel like using next time. Which set of weapons that is. Possibly the barbed sword. That is a definite possibility for the list. I don't think I've actually used a claymore yet. We'll use the claymore next time. And with it... Rude. I know you weren't there for that long, Rose. Take a chill pill. Nice. That worked out perfectly. Jump attacks for the win, guys. Jump attacks for the win. Yeah, so we'll use a claymore. And as far as what we're going to use with it... We'll use the dancer swords. We haven't used those yet. We'll use the dancer swords and a claymore. That sounds like a good time. We'll have a very twirly weapon, and we'll have a very good weapon. I'm down for that. I like that plan. That plan is a good plan. And I approve of this message. Alright, now as soon as our friend gets down here, we can fight. I feel like I'm about to sneeze. I spy a katana. Somewhat long, but not terribly long. That's not a katana, that's the pontiff, or rather the Karthus curved sword. Oh, you're gonna be that guy, okay. Hey, timing. Really? That missed? Death. That was supposed to be a kick, not another R1. I know the timing's not there to get an R1 after that, but there is the proper timing to get a kick, and that works, well, most of the time. Depending on how good they are at rolling away afterwards, it is possible to get the kick. It's significantly more likely. An attempt was made, it didn't work. The game said no. You do not want to kick, you want to do an R1. Had I unlocked for it, then it might have been better had I unlocked and gone for the turn. I don't know if I can actually react quickly enough to realize that and adjust accordingly. To realize that it was going for a regular R1 instead of kick. And then unlock and turn with it. I don't think I could do that. I'll make an attempt the next time, but I don't think it would work. (Clears throat) Hello. I shouldn't have unlocked. Ah, I just wanted the follow-up R2 on it. Really? I walked forward instead of doing it? That makes complete sense. Never mind that I actually had the stamina for it. And he got out of it? What? Okay, enough messing around. That's not something he should have been able to get out of. Especially for the amount of hyper armor that that actually has. Aww. I was hoping the running shield bash would have got it. Yes, yes, yes. Well, what is it? You should have had no way of having enough hyper armor to actually get out of that. I mean, really, an R2 from a Great Axe doesn't have enough hyper armor to break the skill of a greatsword. That one does not make sense to me. I'm sorry. It just, that does not add up. Especially considering it was well, the first one was a charged R2, the second one was uncharged. Either way, it was still a two-handed R2 that had the skill applied to it. So, that makes no sense. I mean, meh. I don't get it. Things like that, see, that's the sort of stuff that you really can't account for. Because it's just nearly impossible to tell in most cases. Like, with poise in Dark Souls 1, as far as the style that it had, you could at least add up the poise, and it would be a set amount at any point in time. You would know how it was affected. You would know this, that, and the other thing about it. With Hyper Armor, you don't have that. You don't have that ability. It's just too complicated to really tell. You're doing a Ricard of, Nice lag, bro! That was only a little bit terrifying. You know, it's never actually mentioned where the undead Prince Ricard comes from. Is it? Like, he's not from Astora, right? And I'm fairly certain his rapier has no information on that. Yeah. It doesn't tell us where he's from. Hmm. Random thing that it just occurred to me. See, that's what should have happened with the other guy. Seriously? No, I'm just out of your range. What are you gonna do? I aimed that way too far over. Chris Marigold, you don't belong here. I think that guy just tried to add me to his friends list after all that. No. 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 I do love the simplified armor look. I do hate the defensive reactive playstyle. That's going on right now, though. Let's wait 10 seconds. Has it been 10 seconds yet? Because he's not doing anything yet. There's the reaction. Wow, what a miss. I barely even moved. Fun! Playing reactive with a longsword. Come on. When I can literally just do nothing for over 10 seconds in a fight, it's not worth taking seriously. I mean, let's be honest. I wasn't even blocking. He didn't even attempt to throw anything at me. I was just literally mirroring the way he was moving for over 10 seconds. Fights like that, I don't get any enjoyment out of them. I've said it before, I'm saying it again. I can't stand fights like that. Yes, there's some merit to playing defensively at times. But playing exclusively defensively and reactively is so boring to fight against. It just makes me lose interest in it. I swear, it does. And I really hope that more people don't take up that playstyle, because if that's the case, I will have no interest in this game anymore. And that's not what I want. I want fights that are fun. I want fights that last a decent amount of time, but a reasonable amount of time. I don't want to, you know, have 10, 20, 30 second lulls in fighting because the person doesn't feel like being aggressive ever, and because I'm copying what they're doing just for the sake of proving a point. Just saying. Pass on that. See, this is a good fight in comparison. That was supposed to be a regular jump attack. Huh? I want jump attacks, game. Can I please? For real, though? do. Good use of the R2. Good use of the distancing on the spear. Overall, a good fight. Very hard to deal with the weapons that I'm using. It was a good fight, though. Well managed. On that note, though, guys, we are going to be done for this episode. So next time, we're picking up the Claymore, as I said. And we are picking up, I forgot what it was. It was the Claymore, and it was... these. I remember. We're good. Everything's right with the world. Anyway, thank you all for watching. I'll see you all next time.